By the almighty divines, you've come. You've actually come. This dreadful black sacrament thing, it worked.
Right then, you prefer to listen, is that it? Well, you must represent the Dark Brotherhood. I certainly wasn't expecting anyone else. So, I'll cut right to the chase. I would like to arrange a contract, several actually. I dare say the most important work your organization has had in, well, centuries. As I said, I want you to kill several people. You'll find the targets as well as their manners of elimination quite varied. I'm sure someone of your disposition will probably even find it enjoyable. But you should know that these killings are but a means to an end, for they pave the way to the most important target. The real reason I'm speaking with a cutthroat in the bowels of this detestable crypt, for I seek the assassination of the Emperor. It's a shocking request, I know, but it is inside the purview of what you Dark Brotherhood types do, isn't it? If history is to be believed, you must understand, so much has led to this day, so much planning and maneuvering. Now you're here, as if the very stars have finally aligned. But I digress. Here, let me give you these. They are to be delivered to your, superior. Rexus! The items.
Here.
The sealed letter will explain everything that needs to be done. The amulet is quite valuable. You can use it to pay for any and all expenses. Is there something else you need? Oh, my furtive friend. When Emperor Titus Mead II lies dead, there will be gold, a fortune in gold, but so much more. It is said that the Dark Brotherhood in recent years has been in decline, that you lack the power, wealth, and respect of days past. Is it not so? If you do this, if you kill the Emperor, oh, how the masses will fear and respect you. Oh, Rexus is no mere servant. He has been with the Motier family since I was a child. I trust the man with my life. In the year 3E41, Emperor Pelagius Septim was murdered in the Temple of the One in the Imperial City, cut down by a Dark Brotherhood assassin. His killing ushered in, shall we say, a necessary change in Imperial policy. There are those now who wish for a similar change. I am sorry, but that's all I'm at liberty to say. I performed the Black Sacrament, contacted you people, because I thought you guaranteed discretion. Is this no longer so? You must deliver those items to your superior, and I must get out of this foul place.
I have vowed to serve Armand Mortier until my dying breath. Best remember that. I have vowed to serve Armand Mortier until my dying breath. Best remember that.
You're back. Good. All right, so, did you meet this Motier? What did he want? You're joking. What's this? By Sithis, you're not joking. To kill the Emperor of Tamriel. The Dark Brotherhood hasn't done such a thing since the assassination of Pelagius. As a matter of fact, no one has dared assassinate an Emperor of Tamriel since the murder of Uriel Septim, and that was 200 years ago. No, she certainly wouldn't. And, for whatever reason, she chose to relay Motier's information to you. I don't know exactly what's going on here, if you're the listener, or this is some fluke, or what, but what we now have before us... You're damn right we'll accept it. If we pull this off, the Dark Brotherhood will know a fear and respect we haven't seen in centuries. You think I'd abandon an opportunity to lead my family to glory? But this is all so much to take in. I need time to read the letter and figure out where we go from here. And this amulet. I'm thinking we need that amulet appraised. I want to know where it came from, how much it's worth, and if we can actually get away with selling it. And there's only one man who can give us what we need. Delvin Mallory. He's a fence, a private operator. Works out of the Ratway in Riften. Give me the letter. Bring Mallory the amulet. Find out everything you can and sell it if he's willing. He'll offer a letter of credit. That's fine. Delvin Mallory and the Dark Brotherhood have... history. He can be trusted.
Take my advice. Don't listen to that talk of the face sculptor down in the ragged flagon. Face butcher is more like it from what I've heard. One snap of the
drifting jail. Or worse.
They represent the reason I'm here. I can't just ignore it.
just don't want you to leave. You're the only good thing that's happened to the city in a long time.
Sorry, I'm afraid I can't help you much right now. I'm currently in mourning.
People of Riften, heed my words.
Looking for work? I need someone to deliver a message.
Mere coincidence. This is one of the signs. The signs that Lady Mara is displeased with your constant inebriation. Put down your flagons filled with your vile liquid and embrace the teachings of the handmaiden of kind.
Take my advice. Stay at the Bee and Barb. The bunkhouse isn't for you.
There's nothing like fishing on Lake Onry. You should try it sometime.
Mara's domain encompasses the emotions we strive the most to embrace. Love, compassion, and understanding. It's difficult to appreciate her gifts in these dark times, but you should consider her light a beacon in the storm. Wonderful! Where to begin? Mara is the goddess of love. The temple spreads her gifts by tending to the sick, the poor, and the lost. We also perform wedding ceremonies for all the loving couples in Skyrim. Yes, if you were ready, of course. Are you familiar with how marriage works in Skyrim? Typically, love in Skyrim is as earnest as the people who live here. Life is hard and short, so there's little room for long courtship. A person who is looking for a spouse simply wears an amulet of Mara about the neck, showing they are available. When another person shows interest and the two agree to be together, one of them comes to the temple and we arrange a ceremony.
What do you say? You think
here you are. Now, remember, people in Skyrim respond to deeds. Yes. You'll find more people interested in your love if you help them. Steal good luck. Mara bless
for
you.
For your sake, I hope you're right. Because if it is...
You're looking for something?
Certainly we should come to some sort of an understanding.
By yours
these people must be made aware of the chaos.
Is that an amulet of Mara? I'm so,
enough, Mara.
Well, yes.
All heard of the dragons.
Why wouldn't I be?
There's no need to use them as an excuse
interested
to harass
in
our
me?
Customers.
Very well, Talon. I'll remove myself from this den of iniquity.
Lead on.
We're not kicking you out. Just keep the sermons at the temple and let us all sin in peace.
All I want is a pair of boots. How hard can it be?
Blessings of Mara upon you.
When are you going to take me away from here, Bully?
Welcome to the...
I told you, I can't just pick up...
All I want is a pair of boots. How hard can it
you
be?
You've never done an honest day's work in your life for all that coin you're carrying, hey lad? I'm saying you've got the coin, but you didn't earn a septim of it honestly. I can tell.
So, Talon, have you reconsidered my...
It's all about sizing up your mark, lad. The way they walk, what they're wearing. It's a dead giveaway.
Shoot.
Look how you sniffed out my little scheme at the North Gate. You knew it was a shakedown and you called him on it. That's what I'm talking about. Wealth is my business. Help me out, and I can add to yours. Would you like a taste? I've got a bit of an errand to perform, but I need an extra pair of hands. And in my line of work, extra hands are well paid. Simple. I'm going to cause a distraction. You're gonna steal Medesi's silver ring from a strongbox under his stand. Once you have it, I want you to place it in Branche's pocket without him noticing. There's someone that wants to see him put out of business permanently. That's all you need to know. I'll be out in the market all day, from 8 in the morning until 8 in the evening. Meet me then. If you've still got the stomach for it.
But at least you're fine.
Anything you say, Mom.
Do you want me to hold your hand as well? You're going to have to sneak over to Medesi's stall and use your lockpick on the strongbox. Then, when you have the ring, you pickpocket Branche and leave it behind. We've been contracted to make sure Branche remembers not to meddle in affairs that aren't his own.
Now,
since we're not the Dark Brotherhood, we're not going to kill him. We're just going to make sure he sits in the prisons for a few days.
I don't trust them.
I'll be at the market come morning.
I don't trust you either.
You better be there.
Family.
Anything
all I want is a pair of boots. How hard can it be?
When are you going to take me away from here, Bully?
I told you, I can't just pick up and leave. I have my wife, my business.
So...
I'm afraid I can't help you much right now. Currently in mourning.
What wasn't I clear about?
I'm sorry, Helga, I can't. Not yet.
Welcome to the Bee and Barb, my lord. If I can interest you in one of our special drinks, you let me know.
So I pay for the weapon shipments, and you oversee their distribution.
Never seen Mjoll this upset about anything. It really gets to her.
That old woman who runs the orphanage has been murdered. Say, didn't I see you coming out of there?
Get in good with Brynjolf, then we'll talk.
Skin us alive if they knew we were doing this.
Why are you always acting like such a big baby? I've gotten us this far.
This far? We're living in a sewer. You said we'd have a house as big as the Blackbriars by now.
You worry about bashing people's heads in. I'll worry about the guild, okay?
Okay, okay.
There's someone there.
Oh, die, damn you! alive if they knew we were doing this.
Why are you always acting like such a big baby? I've gotten us this far.
All right, you want to go?
Son of a...
I am sorry that you left me with no choice.
One there.
Over here.
That's all you got.
That takes care of that.
Found you.
Only a fool lets himself get surrounded.
I suppose I can work with your face. After all, the sculptor cannot always choose the finest clay. Yes, I once practiced my art in the salons and manors of Tamriel's great and good. Now the scum of Skyrim are my only clients. But no matter, the greatest artists are never recognized in their own time. So, are you here as a client? Shall I remake your face? Very well. Just tell me what you desire. Beauty, or hideous deformity, nothing is beyond my skill.
If you're looking for conversation, the flagon isn't the place. Beckel and me, we have a thing going. So I recommend you keep your hands off the merchandise.
Oh, now you must be lost. Best you scurry off while you're able. The Rackway, well, it has a habit of swallowing up the uninvited. Oh, I see. Well now, how is Estrid doing these days, huh? Tell her to stop by sometime. We'd have a drink. Catch up. Ah, but we can discuss that later, yeah? What does the Brotherhood need? Let's see. Where did you get this? No, don't answer. I don't want to know. This is an amulet of the Emperor's Elder Council, specially crafted for each member, who have a small fortune. Ain't something you give up lightly. Look, it ain't my business to tell the Dark Brotherhood its business, but if you killed a member of the Elder Council, you'd better believe... Buy it. This. An Elder Council amulet. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, indeed. Oh, wait just one moment. Here is a letter of credit, usable by Estrid only, for any service or item I can provide, as per our standard arrangement. You bring that back to your lovely mistress, with my regards. I'm listening.
You'd better have coin to pay for your drinks. There's no handouts here.
Stick with me, and he'll never even know you're there. I'm listening.
If you're looking for conversation, Vekkel and me, we have a thing going. So I recommend you keep your hands
off. Got a lot of nerve coming down here. People tend to get hurt.
Sure.
How about you mind your own business about it? And I won't have to get Dirge to toss you into the cistern. All right, then. I wouldn't stay here long if I were you. Thank you.
Okay, Lot. Ready to make some coin.
Gems, potions, exotic ingredients. I have them all.
Do you want me to hold your hand as well? You're going to have to sneak over to Medesi's stall and use your lockpick on the stronglocks. Then, when you have the ring, you pickpocket Branche and leave it behind. I'm ready when you are. Just give the word.
The fairest prices and the highest quality in Skyrim.
Make love like a saber cat, or crush your enemies to dust like a giant. Only a mere 20 gold coins, and all this could be yours.
Can I interest you in some fine goods for Morrowind?
What is it? Dragons?
Jewelry with legendary Argonian craftsmanship.
It helps them accept the unknown.
Knowledge in moments. I'll throw back that missing limb with my genuine Balma blood elixir. Rare treat.
Do you want me to hold your hand as... You're going to have to sneak over to Medesi's stall and use your lockpick on the strongbox.
Greetings, honored friend.
Just give the
Could
word.
I interest you in some fine jewelry? If anything pleases the eye, don't hesitate to make me an offer.
Make love like a saber cat, or crush your enemies to dust like a giant. Only a mere 20 gold coins, and all this could be yours.
If you have any jewelry to sell, I'd be glad to pay you a fair sum in gold for it.
You have questions?
Everything I've got on display, really. Good journey, marsh friend. Beautiful baubles and gleaming gemstones over
Okay,
here.
Lad. Do you want me to hold... You're going to have to... Then, when you have the ring, you pickpocket Branche and leave it behind.
The fairest prices and the
Just give the word. Good. Wait until I start the distraction, then show me what you're made of.
Everyone!
Please.
Gather round.
Please, I need but a scepter.
I have something amazing to show you that demands your attention. Gather round, all. Gather round, all.
other armed off. The other armed off. Come on, bring it on.
Is it this? You can't take that.
Patience, Branchet. This is a rare opportunity. I wouldn't want you to get left out.
That's what you said about the wisp essence, and it turned out to be crushed root mixed with water.
Well, that was a simple misunderstanding. But this item is the real thing. Lads and lasses, I give you... Well...
And just what do you think you're doing?
Come back tomorrow if you wish to buy.
My husband, Bercy, will be the death of me.
Waste of time.
He spends too much time worrying about Riften and not enough about himself.
Looks like I chose the right person for the job. And here you go. Your payment. Just as I promised. The way things have been going around here, it's a relief that our plan went off without a hitch. My organization's been having a run of bad luck, but I suppose that's just how it goes. But never mind that. You did the job, and you did it well. Best of all, there's more where that came from, if you think you can handle it.
Looking to stay alive? Why take a chance?
All right, then. Let's put that to the test. The group I represent has its home in the Ratway beneath Riften, a tavern called the Ragged Flagon. Get there in one piece, and we'll see if you've really got what it takes.
Fresh meats and produce. Get them before they're gone.
Protect all right, Branche. Right. Turn out your pockets. We know you have it.
Have what? What in blazes are you talking about?
Don't play stupid. I said turn out your pockets.
If it's horses you want, you'll want to speak to Hofgrier at the stables.
Wait, what's this ring? This isn't mine.
That's right. It isn't yours.
Looking to stay
you're
alive?
You're under arrest,
why take a chance?
This is insane. I didn't steal anything. I never saw this ring before in my entire life.
We can do this one of two ways. You can walk with me up to the keep, or I can drag your lifeless body. Your choice.
But I...
Very well.
Legendary Argonian craftsmanship.
Buy some armor and live to tell about it. Protect yourself right. Buy armor from Grelka.
Hofgrier's a
you gonna buy something? Or just here for training? Otherwise, move on. I'll teach you how to use it effectively and keep you quick on your feet. Are you serious? I've moved all over. Well, let's say, you look like you could handle yourself. Maybe you could. I need someone to pick up supplies.
From
Naranya.
Living.
Thank you. Just bring it back to me, and I'll... Don't ask any questions,
all
town, right?
Eh?
Just bring it back
here for
to
the
me.
Fishing, I guess.
You gonna stare all day or buy some armor? Just what you see here.
Thank you.
back when you're ready to spend more gold. Goodness knows I could use it.
There's nothing like fishing on Lake
Is that an amulet of Mara? I'm surprised someone like you isn't spoken for. I'm at your service. I will protect you with my life. Tell about it.
I'm telling you, this one is different.
We've all heard that one before, Bryn. Quit kidding yourself.
It's time to face the truth, old friend. You, Vex, Mercer, you're all part of a dying breed. Things are changing.
Dying breed, eh? Well, what do you call that, then?
Stay out of trouble.
Well, color me impressed, lad. I wasn't certain I'd ever see you again. Reliable and headstrong? You're turning out to be quite the prize. So, Now that I've whetted your appetite with our little scheme at the market, how about handling a few deadbeats for me? They owe our organization some serious coin, and they've decided not to pay. I want you to explain to them the error of their ways. Kirava, Bursi Honeyhand, and Helga, do this right, and I can promise you a permanent place in our organization. Honestly, the debt is secondary here. What's more important is that you get the message across that we aren't to be ignored. A word of warning, though. I don't want any of them killed. Bad for business. Good. If you need any details on your marks, I'll be here. Now get going. Helga is a devout follower of Dibella and dotes over the statue to the divine that she keeps at the bunkhouse. Use it as leverage, and she'll cave. Kirava's stubborn, but she's got a soft spot for family. Talk to Talon Jay at the Bee and Barb, and see if you can get something out of him. They're well acquainted, if you catch my meaning. He's as pig-headed a man as you'll ever find. The key is that ugly dwarven urn in his shop. Smash that thing to bits and he'll change his attitude. I'll be here when you're done.
You need advice? Talk to Brynjolf. Got better things to do.
There's no handouts here.
If you're looking for conversation, the flagon is the place. You need advice? Talk to Brynjolf. Got better things to do.
Stay out of trouble, or there's gonna be trouble.
from Grelka.
Sure, sure. I'm a dirty beggar. Why would you want to even speak to me?
Jewelry with legendary Argonian craftsmanship.
So, can I interest you in anything today?
Catchy, isn't it? In my youth, I was a fisherman. I had a beautiful ship named the Brawny Prawn. But the years have a way of creeping up on you. I ended up selling that ship to open this place. Seemed only fitting to name it after her. Well, changed it a bit, I suppose. If I had been smarter, I would have kept my boat. Coming to this city was a big mistake. Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that. Some may call this junk. Me? I call them treasures. It's one of you people. So Brynjolf doesn't even bother to show up himself anymore, eh? What's this message? Petty threats and fist-waving are not going to sway me. You people are all talk, and everyone knows it. You demand payment for protection, and you can't even protect yourselves! Don't fool yourself. It's only a matter of time before you people are run out of Riften. Likewise. Now I have a lot to do, so I'm afraid you'll just have to leave. I'm sorry, you're going to have to... If I had it, I'd pay. There's no need to do that.
Just pay them, Bercy.
I'm sorry, you're going to have to leave. Tell Brynjolf he'll just have to make do without my coin. I'm sorry, you're going to have to leave. Tell Brynjolf he'll just have to make do without my coin.
No! You're going to break it!
This isn't happening.
I'm sorry, you're going to have to leave. Tell Brynjolf he'll just have to do without my coy. Please, I don't have anything to pay you with. Don't destroy my urn!
This isn't happening.
No! That urn was priceless!
All right, I get it. I'll pay on time from now on. Just don't smash anything else. Here, take your gold, and leave me in peace. I hope you're here for friendlier reasons now. After all...
My husband, Bercy, will be the death of me. He spends too much time worrying about Riften and not enough about himself.
Is that an amulet of Mara? I'm surprised someone like you isn't...
Be careful!
What are you doing that for? Please, don't take the statue. It's the only thing of value I have left. Of course not. You expect me to take care of it by myself? My niece Vana helps me with the chores. She'd be more help if she kept her head out of the clouds. She's been with me ever since her parents were killed by bandits and she was dropped in my lap. You! You have my statue! What are you going to do with it? Not Lady Dibella. No, please, I can't lose her. I get the message. Here, take your gold. I hope you choke on it. Look, I got the message. What else did you want?
Food is the best in all of Skyrim. Always as fresh as the day it was collected. My food is the best in all of Skyrim.
What do you want?
Here for a room or something to drink? Throw me some coin first.
What do you want?
I met her when I wandered into Riften a few years ago. Been smitten with her ever since. In fact, I'm thinking of asking her to marry me. In Blackmarsh, tradition dictates we present a potential mate a unique wedding ring to represent our future bond. I already have the gold band, but all I need are 3 flawless amethysts to complete the setting. I was hoping you'd offer. I didn't think it was my place to ask such a favor of you. I thank you. With the rumors going around about how poorly your guild's been doing, she's become much too bold. I'm not that foolish. The last thing I want is a war with your people. Look, I'm only telling you this because I care for her. Don't mistake this as acceptance for what you do. Kirava has some family at a farm just inside of Morrowind. If you mention you know about it, she might just listen to you. Just please don't harm anyone. I couldn't bear the thought. Every Argonian wedding proposal band is supposed to have three flawless amethysts as part of their design. Two of the gems, the ones on the outside, represent the couple to be married. One for the husband, one for the wife. The amethyst in the center represents the Hist, the entity that all Argonians consider a sacred part of our lives. Three, in fact. They're my own recipe. Brought them over here for... First is the Velvet Lechance, which is a mixture of blackberry, honey, spiced wine, and a touch of nightshade. Perfectly safe, I assure you. Second, we have the White Gold Tower, which is heavy cream with a layer of blended mead, lavender, and dragon's tongue on top. Last, and only for the bravest of souls, we have the Cliff Racer, which is firebrand wine, cyrodiilic brandy, flynn, and sujama. If you'll excuse me, I have other things to attend to.
You want something or not? Look, everything was all just a misunderstanding. I didn't mean to tell Brynjolf to go jump off the pier. You tell him I'm sorry, yes? Take this. Every single coin I owe is there. I swear it. Now what did you want? I already paid you. I can't stand this city. It's impossible to make a decision. Now what did you want? I already paid you.
Legendary Argonian craftsmanship.
Stay out of trouble, or there's gonna be trouble.
You'd better have coin to pay for your drinks. There's no handouts here.
I'm busy. Don't you have something to do?
So, job's done and you even brought the gold. Best of all, you did it clean. I like that. Dumping bodies and keeping the guards quiet can be expensive.
Well done. And it would seem I owe you something in return. Here you go. I think you'll find these quite useful. Judging from how well you've handled those shopkeepers, I'd say you've done more than simply prove yourself. We need people like you in our outfit. That's the spirit. Larceny's in your blood. The telltale sign of a practiced thief. I think you'll do more than just fit in around here. What's on your mind? We've run into a rough patch lately, but it's nothing to be concerned about. Tell you what, you keep making us coin, and I'll worry about everything else. Fair enough? Now, if there are no more questions, how about following me, and I'll show you what we're all about.
Mm-hmm.
Mercer, this is the one I was talking about. Our new recruit.
This better not be another waste of the Guild's resources, Brynjolf. Before we continue, I want to make one thing perfectly clear. You play by the rules, you walk away rich. You break the rules and you lose your share. No debates, no discussions. We do what we say, when we say. Do I make myself clear? Good, then I think it's time we put your expertise to the test.
Wait a moment. You're not talking about Golden Glow, are you? Even our little Vex couldn't get in.
You claim this recruit possesses an aptitude for our line of work. So let him prove it. Golden Glow Estate is critically important to one of our largest clients. However, the owner has suddenly decided to take matters into his own hands and shut us out. He needs to be taught a lesson. Brynjolf will provide you with the details.
Mercer, aren't you forgetting something?
Yes. Since Brynjolf assures me you'll be nothing but a benefit to us, then you're in. Welcome to the Thieves Guild.
Welcome to the family, lad. I'm expecting you to make us a lot of coin, so don't disappoint me. Simple. Do as you're told and keep your blade clean. We can't turn a profit by killing. You should talk with Delvin Mallory and Vex. They know their way around this place, and they'll be able to kick some extra jobs your way. Oh, and talk to Tonelia in the flagon. She'll set you up with your new armor. Golden Glow Estate is a bee farm. They raise the wretched little things for honey. It's owned by some smart-mouthed wood elf named Arangoth. We need you to teach him a lesson by burning down three of the estate's hives and clearing out the safe in the main house. The catch is that you can't burn the whole place to the ground. That important client Mercer mentioned would be furious if you did. Aye. The last thing we want to be doing is crossing our clients. Maven prefers that Arangoth remains alive, but if he tries to stop you from getting the job done, kill him. The Guild has a lot riding on this. Don't make me look foolish by mucking it up. Golden Glow Estate brought in a mountain of gold for the Guild. You could almost call it our sweetest deal. Then out of the clear blue, Arangoth stopped sending us our cut. Mercer was, well, angry, to put it kindly. So we send in Vex and find out he's hired a bunch of mercenaries to guard the place. Aye. Arangoth sent the city guard packing and fortified the entire island. In fact, Vex barely made it out of there alive. You should talk to her about it before you go. They're built like small fortresses to resist the weather, but their one weakness is flame. Besides, nothing tells the people of Riften we mean business better than a huge column of smoke. I'll give you one good reason. Maven Blackbriar. Burn all the hives, and she'd have to import honey for Blackbriar meadery, which would cut into her profits. We had an arrangement with Maven. We kept an eye on Golden Glow Estate to make sure the honey kept flowing. If the workers had a dispute, we'd rough them up. If competitors tried to buy honey from Arangoth, we'd steal the shipments. In return, Maven allowed us to extort Arangoth and bring in a huge payout. Let me put it to you this way. Nothing happens in Riften without Maven's consent. One word from her, and you could spend the rest of the Fourth Era in prison. You watch yourself on that island. Those mercenaries don't take prisoners. eyes are on you, lad. Don't disappoint us.
Brynjolf, eh? Let me guess. He just plucked you off the street and dropped you into the thick of things without telling you which way is up. See, that kind of attitude comes from someone who wants to get rich and stay alive long enough to enjoy it. We're gonna get along nicely. So, if you've got the nerve, I've got plenty of extra jobs to help get the guild back on its feet. Look around you. The flagon, the guild, it's all falling apart. A few decades ago, this place was as busy as the Imperial City. Now, you'd be lucky if you don't trip over a skeever instead. Look, I know the others think I'm a bit daft for saying stuff like this, but I'm gonna give it you straight. Something out there is piss drunk mad at us. I don't know who or what it is, but it's beyond just you and me. We've been cursed. I'll tell you what we do. We spit in that curse's face and turn things around down here. Put things back the way they were. That's where you come in. I've got plenty of work available that could guide us down the road to recovery. All you need to do is ask, and we can both come out of this smelling like a rose. Watch yourself out there. The mercenaries are in Goth Hire to train killers. Just ask our poor little Vex. Years ago, the guild used to have a foothold in every major city in Skyrim. You wouldn't dare even lift an apple without checking with us. When things started going downhill around here, it became difficult to keep it all together. We lost fences, influential contacts, and coin. It wasn't long before we lost what we depend on to survive. Respect. By doing these extra jobs and putting some fear into the people, we can take back the cities and start being taken seriously once again. Thanks to Maven Blackbriar, we still have some pull in Riften, but get arrested in Whiterun and you'll be tossed right into the prisons. If we gain the confidence of someone very influential who lives there, by doing a unique job for them, we'd be able to have some leverage there too. The only way we get that special job is by doing smaller ones in those cities until we catch their ear. Then they'll contact me and we're off. If you're looking to get some coin for the fruits of your labor, you should talk to Tanelia. She sounds tough, but she'll cut you a fair deal. I also suggest you spend some time in the training room. Just talk to Vipper. He'll show you around. I handle all the fishing, numbers, and bedlam jobs. The ones with a more personal touch. If break-ins are more your thing, go talk to Vex. Most of the establishments in Skyrim keep their transactions recorded within business ledgers. Your job will be to change the numbers in those books so the shortfalls from our other jobs look legit. Feel like doing a bit of writing? Now that's what I like to hear. Off you go. Oh, you're back. Make us proud.
All eyes are on you.
Before we begin, I want to make two things perfectly clear. One, I'm the best infiltrator this rat hole of a guild's got. So if you think you're here to replace me, you're dead wrong. And two, you follow my lead and do exactly as I say. No questions, no excuses. Easy, huh? So, should I just hand you purses of coin, or are you gonna work to earn your keep? Let me give you a small bit of advice. Nothing in this line of work is easy. If it was, every dreg in the Ratway would be robbing Riften blind. If something's being handed to you on a silver platter, then there's a catch. Steal the platter instead. You get it? Then we understand each other. Good. Now, it's time to get your feet wet. And I don't want to waste a lot of time talking about anything but business. I'm not going to sugarcoat it for you. We're in a bad way down here. Who knows? Old Delvin thinks it's some kind of curse. I think he's crazy. If you want my opinion, I'd say it's just plain old bad luck. You can get out there and start making a name for us again. Make them start fearing us like they did long ago. And while you're at it, make a little bit of coin on the side. Not a bad deal, eh? All right. But if you get arrested, don't blame it on me. Are you kidding me? Ever since the guild's luck turned sour, we haven't had a coin to our name. And when the coin dried up, that's when people started to leave. We had the best of everything down here. The Ratway was a damn palace. The only way this place will ever return to its glory days is if we can finish these extra jobs and start the gold flowing again. The Flagon was once a city beneath the city. We had our own smith, our own alchemist, you name it. If we can make a name for ourselves in Skyrim once again, I can almost promise you those merchants would return. Best of all, we'd have enough gold to throw around so we could start living in the lap of luxury again. Been a while since I've seen one of those. What you've got there is a stone of Baron Zaya. Not like that, it isn't. The stone was pried off of Baron Zaya's ceremonial crown by a thief in order to cover his tracks. I think there were 24 in all. Most people keep them as a curiosity. Some of the guild members have tried to locate them over the years, but they haven't been successful. Well, until now. Look, I only buy things I can turn around quickly for a profit, and no one wants these stones unless they have the whole set. Tell you what, if you find the rest of them, talk to me again. Otherwise, keep it. Maybe it'll bring you luck. Yeah, I did. That wood elf's wit. He's a lot smarter than I expected. Can you believe that fetcher had more than tripled the guard? There must have been 8 of them in there. It was like he was daring us to come and get him. Well, there's an old sewer tunnel that dumps into the lake on the northwest side of the island. That's how I slipped in there. Should still be unguarded. If you're ever in need of some quick coin for items you find on the job, Tenelia is the best fence around. And besides myself, Delvin, Niruin, and Vipper can help you with any sort of training you might need to sharpen your skills. I handle the burglary, shill, sweep, and heist jobs. Most of them involve breaking and entering. If you don't like that kind of work, talk to Delvin. He runs the more up-close and personal jobs. Every now and again, we like to remind the shopkeepers that we're in charge. If that means breaking into their strong boxes and stealing something valuable from them, then so be it. Feel like doing a bit of shopping? The guild way? All right, take this and get out of here. Back with good news, I trust?
So you're the new recruit, huh? Well, looks like you and I are gonna have to get very well acquainted. I'm the fence down here. You come by anything you don't exactly own, and I'll pay you some coin for it. Minus a little slice for the guild, of course. I can also provide a few supplies useful to our trade now and again, for a small fee. Sure, how about I get Dirge to knock you over your head and dump you into the cistern? Look, I've been in this business a long time, and I've seen all types. You can play it tough, or you can play it smart. Whatever. At the end of the day, you'll find that all we care about down here is how much gold you can make us. Good.
Then there isn't much more to say. Here's your armor. Just make sure you put it to good use. I've got coin and I've got merchandise. Let's see what we can do. Why don't you take a look at some of my merchandise and we'll see what kind of... I give special rates to members of the Thieves Guild. Show me what you've got. Usual guild rate. Let's take a look at them. Why don't you take a look at some of my merchandise and we'll see... I give special rates to members of the Thieves Guild. Show me what you've got. Why don't you take a look at some of my merchandise? Usual guild rate. Let's take a look at them. Now, if you'll excuse me, welcome to the cozy little... Well, you could always speak to Delvin or Vex if you're looking for... Or if you're looking for training, we've got plenty of it down here. Delvin, Vex, Nirwin, and Vipper can give you a leg up on that.
Mm-hmm. Out with it. Time is money.
All eyes are on you, lad. Don't disappoint us.
If you're looking for extra work, talk to Vex or Delvin. They'll fix you up.
All... Eyes are on you, lad. Don't disappoint us.
Hey!
What was that?
Come here. A little closer.
Yes, closer. I won't bite. Promise.
Come here.
No, never find me.
Present for you. A nice shiny present.